aibika ukiwa na Yesu. Jina ya mateka leta. I break every bondage. I break every power.
Bwana na kuomba.
This morning, I want to talk about taking care of what you hear. It can build you or it can break you. As a minister, you need to have a sieve. You need to have a buffer zone, so that you are able to take care of what you hear before you allow it to land in your heart, because it can either build you or it can break you. As a minister, you need to be very, very careful. You need to hear more of the word of God and less of the worries and troubles of this world. The news that you pay attention to will affect you either positively or negatively. Make sure that most of your time, if not all of your time, you are under the influence of the word of God. Why do I say so? What you hear will affect what you believe. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. As a minister, you need to take care of what kind of music you listen. As a minister, you need to take care what kind of testimony you listen. By testimony, I mean statements that you hear from people. The more you listen to them, the more they affect your inner man. We should not allow this to happen, that it is easy for a believer to listen to a non-believer and a non-believer changes the believer. It should be the other way around. Non-believers, when they listen to our voices and our statements, they should be able to change their positions, their beliefs, so that they come over to us. Every testimony that you listen, every music you listen, every preaching that you listen, it will affect you, knowingly or unknowingly. After you hear, your brain interprets what you have heard. The human brain has got two parts: the conscious mind and the unconscious mind. Let me deal with the unconscious mind, because that's where our faith works, by listening. The conscious mind does not keep information. It's a short-term memory area. But the subconscious mind is the bigger part of our life in the spirit. It's the place that keeps what we hear, what we talk, is deposited in the subconscious mind. I met one lady, and she had depression as a sickness. Then I was talking to her, and she was telling me Bishop, me, I have no problem. There's nothing that is disturbing me. But when I go to the doctor, I find the pressure is too high. It's uncontrollable. I have to be on drugs. And imagine there's nothing that is disturbing me. As we were talking, I purposed to ask her, what of the last 2 months, has there been anything that had made you to be anxious? Yeah, my business was down for some problem with the guys who were supplying me. I lost some money. But that one is over. I have decided to forgive them and all that kind of thing. Little did she know that the period of the last 2 months when she was anxious, anything she spoke, anything she thought about, anything that went through her mind and through her mouth, it was deposited in the subconscious mind. Then I talked to her and I told her that anxiety is not yet gone. It is still affecting you. And I want you to remove it from the subconscious mind by renewal by the word of God. Believe you me, as we are speaking now, she does not have pressure. What you listen, what you go through will affect your life whether you like it or not. Take care of what you speak about yourself, especially repeatedly. If you hear somebody says, one day I'll kill myself. Wait, one day they will kill themselves. If you allow that mind that things are hard, there's no money, the economy, you know, that kind of language that people normally talk. Things are tough. You know, in the spiritual world, there's no jokes. Do you know that? As a minister, you must be serious. There's nothing like I was joking. Your tongue is anointed to speak. Your ear is anointed to hear. And what you hear is received in the status of anointed message. You take it. You must have the capacity to resist it. Ephesians 4:27, the Bible says what? Do not give a place to the devil. And that's the message I'm talking about this morning. Take care what you listen as a minister. It will affect your ministry. Take care of what you watch. It will affect your ministry. Remember this? Everything you are listening to, anything you are thinking about, anything you are watching is either adding value or it's reducing your value. Nothing just happens. The more you listen to secular music, the more it's reducing you in your spirituality. I met one man in the church, in our church. He had parked his car outside there. And as I was just moving around, I overheard the tapes that he was listening in his car. You know, it looked like it had no harm. These secular talks that people talk, and they talk about some issues and some nonsense, the old traditional talks that they give, some talks like that. I asked him, what are you listening? And he answered me and told me, you know, this is not bad. This is traditional advice and counsel. And I told him, every word has a spirit. And the spirit that you give access into your heart, it will influence you to be of that camp. It's either you are a Christian or you are a traditionalist. Believe you me, his character went down like that. And today as I'm speaking, I don't see his car outside there. One day I met him in town. I asked him, where are you nowadays? told me things are not going the way they are supposed to go. I want you to pray for me. Why? Because sometimes I find myself in a bar. I'm just going to cool down because things are too hot for me. How do you cool yourself with two bottles? Traditionalist. What you listen to will influence you. Take care of what you watch. As a minister, those who are going to the internet, take care. There is pornography there. Take care what you watch. Take care of the music that you listen. It is either adding you or it's reducing you. Take care of what you're watching. It is either building you or it's either reducing you. Take care of your faith. Guard your heart with all your strength, for out of your heart issues of life come out. There are people who are walking but they are dead. They are living but they are dead. Because of what they listen, because of what goes through their mind. They are living a life of pretense, making things seem to look good, yet things are not good. That man the other day, he told me, "Bishop, can I get an appointment with you?" But I told him, "You know what affected you or what is eating you up? Do you remember the day I found you in that car?" Because I came also to find out he had several tips of that kind. What you listen will influence you to become like it. As a minister, allow the word of God to minister to you. Hear. Again, hear and hear and hear repeatedly the word of God. That message will stick in your conscious mind. Then the same message will be downloaded in your subconscious mind. Even when you are not aware, the word will work for you because the conscious mind will deposit everything that you give it to it in the subconscious mind. Even when you are sleeping, your dreams will be influenced by the power of the word of God. Even in your thought life, when you are about to make a decision, your decisions will be influenced by the message that is in your subconscious mind. Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate therein day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then shall you make your way prosperous, and then you shall have good success. The book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. You should speak it. Speak it out. Meditate it. Prosperity comes out of speaking and hearing the book of the law. Your success in ministry is as a result of you hearing the word and speaking the word. Your success in your spiritual life is out of you speaking and hearing the word of God. Take care of what you hear. What testimony are you listening to? What music are you listening to? What message are you listening to every now and then? It will influence you. It will either add value to what you have, or it will reduce what you already have. It can either discourage you. What you hear can either discourage you or encourage you in the level that you are in today. Meaning, we need to realize this. We have a role to play for any change to happen in our lives. We have a big role as an individual, as a minister, to play for change to occur in our ministries, in our lives, in our businesses, in whatever, by what we choose to listen, by what we choose to speak. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So as a minister, it is your decision, purpose, to hear more of positive issues. I repeat, do you want positive change in your life? Purpose in your life to make a decision to listen to positive message, positive testimony. Purpose as an individual, that I will not listen to negative messages. I will not allow anybody to tell me that it is impossible. I will only listen to positive messages. I love David, a man after God's own heart. Remember the story when he went in the battlefield? He went to his brothers. Instead of his brothers encouraging him, they started accusing him. They started demeaning him. What happened? David left them and he went to other people. Look at the other people that David connected with. What the spirit of David wanted to add value in his life, that is what he gave attention to. He listened to the guy who said, the person who killed this Philistine, hey, the king will give him a wife. And David was not married. What are you lacking? Can you look for people who are telling you how you can get it? People who tell you things are not good. Can you stop giving them attention? Can you listen to the person who is telling you that with God all things are possible? Lift your right hand and declare, with God all things are possible. Hallelujah. You need to connect to that message. You need to go and listen to that person who will tell you that it is possible for somebody to come out of a lowly place to a high place. Praise be to God. Go and listen to that person again and again and again. Your life will be changed. When David listened to those guys who were telling him that this guy will not pay taxes, this guy will be exempted from, you know, whatever that has been placed up upon all the other people, David was getting it. Say, wow, that is me. That is me. Can you always see yourself with a positive attitude? Always see yourself as the one who is going to make it next. Always carry positive information, positive mind, positive attitude, willing only to listen to what will encourage you and what will build you up to become what God has created you to be in this world. Praise be to God. He forsook his brothers and went to the guys who were telling him what he wanted to hear. Choose what you want to hear. Don't just take every information, every garbage. You know, there are so many frequencies here. So many frequencies. So many radio stations are talking. I overheard the other day, there's a guy in Kampala who told people the world is coming to an end. And he told them to sell everything that they have. And they sold. And up to today, the world has not ended. Now, what about that guy who sold his plot? What about that guy who sold all that he had? It's a big question. Can you seek the right information that you need to hear? Guard what you hear. Guard your heart. Don't give your heart garbage. Choose the information that will get in your heart. Praise be to God. I'm showing you of characters in the Bible. Because you are one of them, you can make it in life. I remember I met a preacher when I was a hawker. And he told me there are people who are living a life that is not theirs and God can change their life. I saw this preacher is talking to me. I chose to listen to his words. That man is called Apostle Ngang, and he told me, you young man, God will take you far because I paid attention. And for sure, I'm seeing the value of those words today. God has taken me far. And I know this morning, God is taking you far. God is going to build you up to become what he created you to be in Jesus' mighty name. 1 Samuel chapter 21 and verse 10. And David arose and fled that day for fear of Saul and went to Achish, the king of Gath. And the servants of Achish said unto him, is not this David the king of the land? Did they not sing one to another of him in dances, saying, Saul has slain his thousands, and David his 10,000s? And David laid up these words. Look at verse 12. And David laid up these words in his heart, and was so afraid of Achish, the king of Gath. And he changed his behavior. Look at that. And he changed his behavior before them, and feigned himself mad in their hands, and scrabbled on the doors of the gate, and let his spittle fall down upon his beard. Then I said Achish unto his servants, lo, you see the man is mad. Wherefore then have you brought him to me? Have I need of madmen that you have brought this fellow to play madman in my presence? Shall this fellow come into my house? Here David is the same David who was anointed by Prophet Samuel. You know that? The first one, Ahimelech, the priest is talking to David and telling David, David, are you asking for a sword? Yes, I have one. Only one is remaining here. It is wrapped with some clothes down there. It belongs to Goliath, the giant that you killed in the valley of Elah. He was bringing the spirit of victory, the testimony of victory over David. And look at how David is charged. He says, for sure, there's no other sword like that. I am ready to go with it, to battle with it. And he went, he took the sword, and he was ready to go out. And he went out victorious, full of power, full of the Spirit of God, ready to face any challenge. Down there, he goes to Achish. Remember, David and King Achish, they were good friends. They had gone for many battles and they had won the battles together. But here comes a moment and David is before King Achish. Then some people down there, they start speaking, the Philistines, and they tell Achish, is this not David the Israelite who killed Goliath? Who won many battles for Israel? Is it not this guy, the one whom the Israelites were singing, that he has killed 10,000 of the Philistines? And Saul has killed 1,000. Achish, are you bringing David on our side? He will continue to, he killed our men. He will continue to kill us. And when he heard that testimony, the Bible says, and David feared greatly because of hearing and giving those words a place in his heart. He feared greatly an anointed man of God. A man after God's own heart, a warrior, a killer of giants. He feared greatly. And the Bible says he started trembling because of hearing. The Bible says he went to a certain door and he started scratching like a madman. Bible says he again started releasing spittle from his mouth, and the spittle could go down his beard. You know a madman, the way he is, he pretended to be mad because of what he had. A killer of giants. He chose to listen to that information instead of that information building him. It discouraged him. It made him fearful. It made him useless, behaving a madman before King Achish. What you listen can either upgrade you or it can degrade you. Look at the priest Ahimelech when he's talking to David. He's reminding him of how he had killed Goliath. And he said, his sword is here. That testimony had built his faith. And he said, give me that sword. In fact, that is the best sword that I can use for battle. He was ready to go for battle. Look on the other side. He gets negative information. He pretends to be a madman. He pours spittle on his beard. He pretends to be a madman. Take care of what you listen. Every time and any time you listen the word of God, it adds value to your spirit. It gives you value in your heart, and your faith grows. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. What are you listening? What kind of music are you listening? It's either building you, or it is either breaking you. Don't say there is no harm in music. Especially youngsters, you young men and women. Don't say there is no harm in music. There is great harm. Because it affects your heart. It might not affect your mind at the moment, but it is affecting your heart. Romans 10, what the Bible says? With your mouth you confess, with your heart you believe, and you are saved. If you can get information, wrong information in your heart, it can destroy you. If the same information can give you faith to receive salvation, information that gets in your heart, it can bring destruction. Take care of what you listen. Don't allow anybody to give you negative. Never absorb. Ephesians 4:27. Do not give a place to the devil. Take care of the information you receive. Nowadays things are not good. Tell them, for me, nowadays things are good. The promise of the Lord is from one glory to another glory. Can you declare, I'm going far? I didn't hear your voice. Can you declare, I'm going far? My ministry is becoming better and better and better and better. Let me show you something today. Anytime there is something which is negative, always raise your eyes above the negativity and see the positivity of it in Jesus' name.